Coach Spates, Flow Nationals 2014. First off, recruiting, the name of the game. I've talked to most of the coaches here. How important is recruiting to, you know, you were at Cornell.
Yeah.
You coach one of the GOATs. And when I say GOAT, I mean greatest of all time, Kyle Dake.
Yep.
How important is recruiting, you know, in Southern Illinois, Edwardsville? How important is it?
It's huge. I mean, I knew that coming in, you know, to this year. All the coaches that I talked to kept telling me, you know, you can't do it till you get your guys in there. And I was, you know, brave enough to think that I could. But, you know, as I find out, you got to get the good kids in there. We got to get the top recruits. So
you've seen it at all facets. You've seen Rob Cole. You've seen your dad recruit too. You loved it.
Yeah.
Growing up, what's that like? You know, growing up, your dad being Oklahoma Sooners, Cornell. He's at a couple different schools.
Yeah.
But what's that like seeing your dad recruit?
It was crazy. You know, we'd be at home at night, and that's back in the day of the old school phones before cell phones, you know, and he was punching in the credit card number all the time and having recruits call him to collect. And so it was interesting seeing him recruit, you know, especially going from Cornell when they were a lower level program and just trying to get in with those top kids to where he was at Oklahoma, and we were able to bring in some, you know, pretty big name guys just because of the name of the school and Oklahoma's history.
Looking at the levels of support you've seen from administration, athletic departments, you've seen it all.
Yeah.
You're at Missouri.
Yeah.
You know, you obviously Oklahoma, that's what you're born, you're raised on that. Yep. Cornell raised on that. And then you go and you actually coach at Cornell. The support of Cornell is pretty much second to none.
Yeah.
Oklahoma, great support, Mizzou support. Where would you rate Edwardsville, SIU Edwardsville?
I mean, we're not where we need to be, and I think the support in all those different schools, like you mentioned, it comes from different areas. You know, Cornell, they get supported really well by the school, but the alumni pick up a ton, whereas Oklahoma, the alumni don't have to pick up as much because the school, you know, has football money. So we're not where we need to be. We're very close to fully funded. The athletic department really did a good job of putting money back in and supporting us. We just, you know, finished a new weight room, looking at a new wrestling room here, or an expansion on the wrestling room here in the next year or so. So they're really supporting us, and the alumni are stepping back up. They're excited about what we're doing. You know, we got to continue to go in the right direction, but we're getting them back on board. So we're getting the support that we need.
How big was it for you personally, maybe morally at least, you know, a moral victory? You have a constant conference champ,
yep,
and a qualifier this year,
yep,
heavyweight. 74, you have another guy that's right there.
Yeah.
You know, barring an injury, you know, he's probably going to be at the tournament. But what's that mean to you as a coach to get a qualifier this year?
It was very mixed emotions because after the conference tournament, I felt like we wrestled so poorly. I was really down about it. Some of it was due to injury and that type of thing. Our very last match of the tournament, kid dislocates his elbow in the finals. So it was frustrating in some respects, but then again, it was our first Division I qualifier since the 80s. I think 1987 was the last year. So it was our first conference champ. You know, now some of those years we weren't D1, so we couldn't go, but still pretty exciting, and everybody really saw some gain throughout the season. And to have our first qualifier, now that kind of opens up the door for next year. It's not like this big thing that nobody's ever done. You know, now we have a guy that's been a qualifier, a guy that's been a conference champ, so that was huge for us.
Looking at vision, you know, talking vision to programs, and having a plan.
Yep.
What would you say is a realistic plan for Southern Illinois Edwardsville?
Well, I think that, you know, in the short term, we're trying to just qualify guys to nationals, get All-Americans, you know, have our first NCAA champ. We had Division I All-Americans back in the 70s and 80s, but we never had a champion. I think the best we had is a couple of semifinalists. So, you know, those are the smaller steps. And then as we get better, you know, looking for team conference championship, looking to put multiple guys on the stand. And then, you know, I think we're in a place being where we're at in the Midwest and with the support growing from the administration and the alumni, I think we could be a top program. Do I think that's 2 years down the road? No, but I think we could be up there.
What's it like, you know, going from both ends of the spectrum as far as big football money, big Ivy League money and Ivy League support systems, you know, that's the big thing. The alumni's huge, obviously, Cornell. And then, you know, Missouri's got a great support system. It's only growing, you know, getting better, you know, even better than when you were there. What's that like, you know, then you go to SIU Edwardsville. It's got to be a little bit of a culture shock.
Well, it definitely was. And luckily, I had that experience at Missouri because I was in the exact same situation. I was Coach Smith's first recruiting class, and, you know, it was exactly what where we're at right now. So I experienced it, but I knew I was spoiled. I went out into coaching. I went to Oklahoma our first 2 years. We were third. I went to Cornell our first year. First 2 years, we were second. So I knew it was coming. I tried to prepare myself, but losing, I mean, nobody likes to lose at this level. So no matter how much you prepare yourself for it, to come out and have a tough year like we did, it was hard. It was difficult.
Does your dad give you a lot of advice?
A lot of advice, yes. I got so much advice from him, from so many other great coaches I've been lucky enough to be underneath. And at one point, I kind of said, hey, I appreciate the advice. I need to kind of do it on my own way. But I still am always, I'm calling him, I'm calling Smith. I mean, you know, I talked with Lee Prince as one. He doesn't get a lot of recognition, but Lee was a huge mentor of mine coming through the Missouri program and ever since. So I've got a ton of great coaches that I can call, and I'm lucky in that situation.
Do you go after the big recruits here, the blue chippers, or do you try and stick with the 5th through 8th place guys around the 12? What do you go after?
Well, this year coming in, I was late in the game. I got here in August, you know, so it was tough. I think we're going for more of the 5 through 8 type kids. But, you know, in the future, I think when we have kids, especially when we have kids from our local area or from Illinois, I mean, we've got to go after those kids, the Missouri kids. We're going to go after them, and hopefully there's something in our school that they like. You know, not everybody wants to go to a Penn State or an Iowa. I mean, that's the appeal for a lot of guys, but a lot of guys, they like a smaller school, or they want the challenge of rebuilding a program. So, you know, that's kind of what we're banking on in some of these top recruits.
Do you like the rules here where you get to see a guy?
I do,
build, yeah. Ride time, wrestle on the edge of the mat. How much, yeah, do you like that?
I do, especially for the riding time thing. And people, you know, riding time gets such a bad rap. But, I mean, it's really exciting. I'd like to see maybe not the dropping down to the ankle and that type of stuff. But when you're in the middle of a good ride out at the end of a period or for the end of the match with riding time in factor, it's pretty exciting in my opinion. So I like to see that so you can see who can transition into college.
All right, you got anything else for me, or are you just going to enjoy wrestling for the next 2 years?
I don't think so. Yeah, we're going to enjoy the wrestling.
You going to enjoy some Bader time? Do you get a little, yeah, Bader time?
I got to sneak up behind him and beat him up a little bit. But, yeah, hopefully.
All right, hey, thanks for the time.
Right,
enjoy the wrestling,
it.
And good luck recruiting.
All right, thanks. Appreciate it.